The experiment done by Giger and Master, as suggested by Rutherford. It was to study what is there inside an atom. And whenever we want to study what is there inside something, what we do? We break it, open it, and see what is there inside. Break it. How can we break something? Take a hammer, hit it, it will break. That was required for the atom. So what was the fundamental principle? We should have one atom. We should have a hammer which is able to hit that atom and break it. And then whatever comes out of it, we should be able to study that, to recognize that. So we have to work on that. The first thing is, how can we achieve one atom? So Giger and Marsden, they thought that a molecule or a material is made of atoms, and the atoms are located like this, that is, these are atoms. Okay, this is a material. This atom, this atom, this atom, if we hit it, it will hit this. There are so many. The impact will be borne by many. Okay. Then he thought another thing, that if we make this sheet of this material, if we make it thin, then what will happen? Answer is, if we make it thin, then it will have this shape. There are, out of this four lane, they have become only two lines. If we make it thin, further thin, then what will happen? If we make it as thin as possible, this, then we get a small, we get a thin foil. You have seen the foil? It will become so thin that we are able to see around it. If you make it thinner than this, what will happen? It will get punctured. It will break. So, I take a metal because the metal has ability to expand when we hit it. So, this metal, and they took the best metal which have got very large atoms. They could find out that the atoms are large because of the weight. So, they took gold. Gold is the heaviest metal, and it has a property that it could be expanded one. That is was the reason. Two reasons. Number one, atoms are heavy, they must be large. Larger it is, better it is for study purpose. Number two, they have a property that they can be expanded without breaking. And that property was best in gold. So they took gold material and then spin it like this, 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 and this become a very thin foil. Such a thin foil that if you place it here, you can see through it as if there is nothing there. It is so thin. Okay. So a thin foil was made. Now, if there is thin foil like this and there are atoms, so when they hit it, they needed something to hit, like bullet, which will hit atom. So they were thinking that if an atom is like this, there should be something to hit it. Naturally, this should be smaller than this, and it should have so much energy that it should be able to hit it. So much energy, so much speed. Our guns and other things cannot give that much speed to a very, and this should be very, very small. So they searched all around and they found a suitable material. That material was alpha particle. What was alpha particle? If we get a radioactive material, from radioactive material there is a radiation and the particles eject out automatically. Those ejecting particles were not ejected by somebody who is giving it energy to eject out, but it is because of own reactions inside. We will study it in the chapter of nucleus. It is because of its own energy, atomic energy, and because of that they were coming out with a very high speed and they had a lot of weight, lot of mass. So that used to work as a very good hammer to hit, because they had mass, they had velocity and they can hit anything. And they had charge also, that was one thing, we could not avoid it. So alpha particle was the best thing, very small particles compared to an atom, they had got energy because of their high velocity and they have got mass, so they were good enough to have a momentum to hit something so that it can break. So alpha particle were chosen because of that. So they chose the atoms of gold because in the experiment it is possible to make a film which will expose a single atom not supported by different atoms, a single atom. So when there is a single atom as a target, then they could bombard alpha particles here. All these alpha particles are bombarded on this and they studied the effect. What effect? After hitting the atom, what will happen? After hitting the atom, maybe the atom breaks up, maybe it does not break. But what happens to these alpha particles? At least that we can observe. So they made an arrangement to observe what happens after collision. Now there were three things ready. Number one, gold atom to be studied. Number two, alpha particles which will hit it. Number three, an arrangement which will give us the study of what happens after the collision. And with all this experiment, we will form our opinion. They formed their opinion, Rutherford formed his opinion, and he gave us the first model of, that is known as Rutherford model of atom. So now we will see what was the design of Giger and Marsden experiment. So that we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you.